The grace of God is not an excuse for us to sin and to continue living in sin, beloved. In Titus chapter 2, verse 11 onwards to 14, it states, "For the grace of God, which we already have established, is Jesus Christ. So for the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men." Who is the grace of God that brings salvation and has appeared to all men? Is it not Jesus Christ? So the grace of God that bringeth salvation hath appeared to all men, teaching us that denying ungodliness and worldly lusts, we should live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. So what is Jesus Christ? Who is the grace of God that brings salvation to all men? What is Jesus Christ teaching us? He is teaching us that we are to deny ungodliness, that we are to deny our worldly lust, that we should live soberly, that we should live righteously and godly in this present world, not living righteously and godly in the world to come, but living soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world. So the grace of God demands us to live soberly, righteously today in our lives where we are in this present world. So the grace of God is not or could ever be an excuse to sin when it is sin that separates you from God, beloved. God cannot be here trying to save you from sin, separating you from sin while you are drowning yourself in it. So if Christ by his grace is seeking to separate us from sin, we then, beloved, as the children of the Most High God, should be following the Lamb whithersoever he goeth. And verse 13 says, "Looking for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of the great God, our Savior, Jesus Christ, who gave himself for us that he might redeem us from all iniquity. So what does God want to do? What is Christ trying to accomplish in our life by giving us the grace to do so, by appearing for our salvation? He is doing something special, which is to redeem us from all iniquity and purify unto himself a peculiar people, zealous of good works. Therefore, beloved, grace is transformative. The grace of God is not an excuse for us as the children of God, the people of God, to sin. The grace of God is not applied to our sinfully corrupt and polluted lives as Christians who are hiding under a cloak of sin, saying, "I can't do any better." If you are saying that you can't do any better, you are denying the power of God unto salvation that has appeared to all of us through Jesus Christ. It means then you are rejecting the grace of God that has been provided on your behalf. And this is why Romans chapter 6 verse 14 to 18 says, "For sin shall not have dominion over you, beloved, for ye are not under the law but under grace." So if you are under grace, sin does not have dominion over you. What is sin? Sin is the breaking of the law of God. So when you experience the grace of God, you do not set for yourself a lifestyle of continually breaking the law of God, because you are under the grace of God. And this grace, which is Jesus Christ, teaches you, beloved, that you are to deny ungodliness. This grace teaches you that you are to deny worldly lust and to live soberly, righteously, and godly in this present world, in this day, in this age, in this modern society, this is what grace is teaching you, beloved. And this grace teaches you that you are to look for that blessed hope and the glorious appearing of Jesus Christ, who gave himself for you to redeem you from all iniquity, beloved, and to purify your life, purify you unto himself, a peculiar person, zealous of good works. And verse 15 of Romans chapter 6 continues, What then, beloved, shall we sin? Because we are not under law, but under grace. Is grace an excuse for us sinning? Is grace an excuse for us to live sinful lives and expect the blood of Jesus Christ to cover the sins that we are unrepentant of and we do not care to take all of his strength to resist? What then, beloved? Shall we sin because we are not under the law, but under grace? God forbid. Know ye not that to whom ye yield yourselves servants to obey, his servants ye are to whom ye do obey, whether of sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. But God be thanked that ye were the servants of sin, but ye have obeyed from the heart that form of doctrine which was delivered you. Being then made free from sin, ye became the servants of righteousness. How are we made free from sin, beloved? Through the grace of God, which is Jesus Christ, the power of God unto salvation, beloved, because the grace of God is the favor of God in affording you an opportunity to recognize where you have gone wrong, an opportunity to repent, and the power to take hold of God's strength in that repentance and to keep that repentance real and current in your life, to live a godly life in this world for the world to come. This is the Word of Life with Andre Knight. Grace is not an excuse for us to continuing living in sin.